Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. Today's game is between the Northeastern Huskies and the Virginia Tech Hokies. Here are a couple of the go-to guys for each team, Bill. And there is the starting lineup for each team.
We have two excellent players at the point guard position. They usually do a great job of getting their teammates involved. Something we should definitely keep an eye on, Gus.
And, of course, how the teams will set the tempo.
Well, I think if they can focus on some of these keys here, they'll be in a position to win.
The Huskies get possession, and away we go. Nice pass to the low block. Jump shot. And he can't get the bounce. Grabs the rebound. The Hokies motion for around one.
Understanding what type of shot you want is essential in this offense.
Robinson handles the pass. He shoots from the top of the key. And hits. Robinson is just as skilled scoring as he is distributing the basketball.
You know he's a real talent. He can set up his teammates for open looks and really has a nose for the goal.
He was determined to get to the rim.
A nice job getting to the hole. A gutsy take. I like that mentality.
They've got him trapped now, Raph.
They've got him in trouble, Gus.
On the left side. Foul on the play. Too aggressive on defense here. He winds up with the foul.
Now you always get your hand reaching in. You get in trouble.
Here's another solid junior build.
You want leaders on your team. At least I did when I was coaching. Having a couple of upperclassmen will always be to your advantage.
Hits that one. Foul shot, no good. The Huskies running their zone offense.
Very effective because of the power on the glass. It opens up that opportunity for tips.
Nice low post play. Good entry down into the box. Thanks for joining CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. I'm Gus Johnson alongside Bill Raftery. And misses. They work the perimeter. He tries the three.
Oh!
And lays it in. The Huskies and now getting set up for around one.
If you don't help out, they just kill you.
He shoots from the top of the circle. Off the mark. Pulls down the rebound. On the outside. Up and in. Ha ha! The great backdoor play.
Just a terrific look to the cutter. Going strong to the tin for the easy finish.
Careless mistake there. The Huskies in a hurry. Oh, what a strip coach. On the left side. Fires. He can't get it to go. Give me that. Out on the wing.
lays it up and in.
Walker receives the pass. Jump shot. Shots off.
That's a good stop defensively. One shot and get it out.
Cross court. He shoots from outside. No luck from downtown. It's a call for the foul. Too aggressive on defense here, and he winds up with the foul.
You always get your hand reaching in, you get in trouble. Seniors are tough to come by these days. When you have a few of them on your roster, it really helps from a coaching standpoint. They know what's expected of them, and they're most likely to deliver.
No good. Grabs the rebound. On the left side. Shots up. He got it up and in. The Huskies, and they're in their motion offense, working with four around one.
Well, if you have a big guy that can find people, it really puts a lot of pressure on the D.
Nice rejection.
That's how you put the pressure on the defense. Push the ball in transition.
They work it around the perimeter. Can finish. Walker handles the feed. Fires.
Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
The Huskies in their four around one motion.
Dribble drive, the ability to understand when to put it on the deck and when to screen.
This layup is definitely worth a second look.
Gotta make those, Gus. It's incredibly deflating when you don't.
They're set to throw it in from the side. The Huskies now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
And what they do is put it on the deck, creating a pinch, and then find the open guy.
Top of the key. Jump shot.
How about that, Gus?
They work it around the perimeter. Turns it over. Dump it inside. Fires. He missed it. Nice rebound. Robinson receives the ball. Jump shot. And he can't get the bounce. They work the perimeter. He goes for three. He nails the long-range bomb. This is what I call home court advantage. The crowd is on their feet. Tough place to play. Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive, but you just gotta know when to back off.
And we'll go to the free throw line. Rims off. Rims out. Takes the rebound. Here they go in transition. Out on the left wing. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy. Now they work it around the perimeter. Off the mark.
Push it.
They work the perimeter.
Put a little English on it.
We've got a timeout. More CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA right after this. And we're back ready to get things going again after the timeout. In the post. Fires. And it goes in.
Nice job there of hitting that mid-range shot. There was a time when guys were reluctant to take that shot.
The Huskies on offense. They have four guys on the perimeter and one down low.
Great passing lanes to the big fella.
Shots up. Grabs the board. On the wing. Change of possession. Let's take a look at this young man's awesome performance so far tonight.
As a coach, Cuss, it's always a bonus when players step up. He'll continue to be a nightmare for this defense if they don't change things up.
Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. Dump it inside.
Inside.
Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the corner.
Perfect.
A great trap initiated by the defense. The Huskies set up into their four around one offense.
If you have a good postman, it's very tough to defend. Everything centers on him.
Dump it inside. 7 minutes left on the... Swatted away! Now we've got a turnover. On the outside. He shoots from the corner. He can't get it to go. What a rebound. Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the corner. Count it. The Huskies motion for a round one.
Understanding what type of shot you want is essential in this offense.
How about this kid? Huh?
Six minutes left on the game clock. On the left side. Jump shot. No.
Boy, the coach will be happy with that effort.
On the left side. From the corner. Not this time. Fired. He missed it. Rips down the board. He attempts the trifecta. Nice look.
Bam.
The Huskies now running the four around one.
Must be alert on that defensive end because guys get pinned and they can step out and knock down the deep one.
5 minutes left on the game clock.
And lays it in.
Receives the pass in the paint. It's a call for the foul. Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive, but you just gotta know when to back off.
Now they'll line him up. Free throw is good. The Huskies running their zone offense.
Very effective because of the power on the glass. It opens up that opportunity for tips.
The freshman is a bit careless with the basketball. Out on the left wing. Pushing in transition. The senior. Rath, they've got him right where they want him. Call for the foul. On the left side. He shoots from the left of the circle. And he can't get the bounce. The Huskies running their zone offense.
Now this particular offense is extremely tough because they get into the high-low look.
We're at the 4 minute mark. In the lane. Shots off. Offensive rebound. Up and in. Ha ha! Turns it over. Now on the run. Here comes the pain. This guy is really known as a power guy.
When he gets it down deep on the box, this kid can knock it down.
And he lays it up and in. The Huskies and now getting set up. Four around one.
If you don't help out, they just kill you.
Three minutes left on the game clock. The shot clock shows 10. The Huskies set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
On the right side. The junior. A terrific backdoor play on that last trip.
Oh, really caught the D on their heels. A great cut to the rim. A terrific feed for that easy completion.
The ball stripped. shots off.
Get out and fill.
The Huskies now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to their man-to-man. They find the open guy.
Can't escape the pressure.
The young guy has some trouble with that trap.
We are at the two-minute mark. Looking for a good shot. Jump shot. Off the mark.
See the floor. He can get some easy fast breaks.
On the left side. Careless mistake there. Get over. Jump up. Get it down on the low block. Fires. He can't get it to go. They work the perimeter. 1 minute left on the game clock. Way out on the right wing. In the lane.
Got it!
On the right side. No. What a rebound. Turnover by the freshman. Cross court. He got it up and in. A great finish on that backdoor feed.
Oh, what an explosive cut to the tin and just a terrific feed. What a finish, Gus.
With the first half in the books, we're now ready for the road to the Final Four. Stay tuned. Our game summary.
We've seen a lot of action and some impressive play here today. A look at these numbers can give you an idea of who has been doing what.
Here's a look at how both teams are doing with their keys to the game.
Gus, it looks like they're going with the minimum.
They work it around the perimeter.
Pull up jumper. It's good.
The Huskies set up four around one.
Gus, tough because guys can make shots and yet they can penetrate and kick.
On the outside. In the lane. And he gets it. The Huskies set up into their four around one offense.
If you have a good postman, it's very tough to defend. Everything centers on him.
Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
Chance for an easy one. Gets it. No, not this time. You can finish. Down in the low block. Jump shot. He missed it. Rips it down. Now they work it around the perimeter. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy for this guy. Out on the left wing. He shoots from the corner.
How about that?
He manages to keep it in. The Huskies now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
And what they do is put it on the deck, creating a pinch, and then find the open guy.
Out on the right wing. Ten on the shot clock. He attempts the three. Can't connect from the three-point line. Robinson turns it over. Now in transition. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. Way out on the right wing. He looks for three.
That's how to stretch the defense, Gus. If you can make those, offensively your team becomes really difficult to guard.
The Huskies, and they're in their motion offense, working with four around one.
Well, if you have a big guy that can find people, it really puts a lot of pressure on the D.
They work it around the perimeter. He puts up the tray.
Big time dagger.
The Huskies are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post, Rack.
Well, anytime you get a player on the high post who can make plays, you put pressure on the D, and that can lead to some easy open looks.
Got it in the low block. Fires the sophomore. The Huskies in their four around one motion.
Dribble drive, the ability to understand when to put it on the deck and when to screen.
With 10 to shoot on the shot clock. In the post, the Huskies working, changing it up against the zone.
That's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings.
On the baseline.
Put a little English on it.
The Huskies on offense. They have four guys on the perimeter and one down low.
Great passing lanes to the big fella.
Now with 10 to shoot. And he can't get the bounce.
Inside.
The Hokies set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
Rap, it's been a great team effort for these guys.
Gus, it makes things really difficult for the defense when multiple players are contributing at the offensive end. I doubt they were prepared for this.
In the paint. And lays it in.
Got time.
The Huskies and now getting set up for around one.
If you don't help out, they just kill you.
Left side. Get over.
Get it down on the low block. Jump shot. Off the mark.
What a rebound. It's fine.
The Huskies running their zone offense.
Now this particular offense is extremely tough because they get into the high-low look.
On the inside. Up and in. Ha ha! On the right side. And he lays it up and in. The Huskies running their zone offense.
Very effective because of the power on the glass. It opens up that opportunity for tips.
Can't get it to go.
Oh, what a good rebound there, Gus. You got to secure those ones. The more rebounds you get, obviously, the better.
They work it around the perimeter.
You can make your ass for your mommy.
Cross court. Fired. Shots off.
Oh, physicality.
Dump it inside. Inside. Power jam. Work it around the perimeter. Turnover. He'll want that one back. They work the perimeter. Jump shot.
How about that, Gus?
Looking for a good shot. He unloads the three with no luck. Ah, he got it up and in. This may have him right where they want him, Raph. The Huskies motion for around one.
Understanding what type of shot you want is essential in this offense.
Can finish. Ball handler may be in a bit of trouble, Raph. On the outside. The Huskies now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
And what they do is put it on the deck, creating a pinch, and then find the open guy.
Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. They work the perimeter. Now with 10 to shoot. In the post. Fires.
Perfect. That's how to keep the D on their toes. Take some threes and some baskets in the paint area and then surprise them from the mid-range.
The Huskies now running the four around one.
Must be alert on that defensive end because guys get pinned and they can step out and knock down the deep ball.
And he's fouled. Once again, a case of being too aggressive defensively.
There's nothing wrong with being aggressive, but you just gotta know when to back off. Opportunity here to put some points up, Gus, with the clock stopping.
Misses the free one. Gets the ball. Entry pass in the paint. Shots off.
pulls it down. 7 minutes left on the game clock. On the wing. Jump shot. Shots off. Pulls down the rebound. They work the perimeter. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy. In the paint. Second team foul. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You've really got to know your limitations, Gus.
With the free one. He gets it to go. Gets two at the charity stripe. The Huskies working, changing it up against the zone.
And that's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings.
On the inside.
Put a little English on it.
Fires. He got it. The Huskies, and they're in their motion offense, working with four around one.
Well, if you have a big guy that can find people, it really puts a lot of pressure on the D.
He launches a three, and he is no good from downtown. They work it around the perimeter. And he's fouled. The Huskies are really taking it to the defense around the hoop, Bill.
It can come from any player on the court in a number of different ways. But it's always the same effect. Higher shooting percentage. It also opens things up around the perimeter.
Looking for a good shot. Well, Raph, this could go down to the wire.
You've got to love these close ones, Gus. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss.
Gus, you've got to love these tight ones. So much on the line here. One wrong move is all it takes. There's no room for error.
On the outside. He shoots from the corner. Nails it from downtown. That trap could spell trouble. The Huskies, and now getting set up, four around one.
If you don't help out, they just kill you.
Ten on the shot clock. Minutes left on the game clock. Misses from the outside. The Hokies now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to their man-to-man. They find the open guy.
They work it around the perimeter. And we'll get a change of possession. At the midway point in the half, let's take a look at how these two have performed tonight.
There are a lot of things that don't always show up in the stat sheet, Gus. These guys could have a horrible game up to this point, so long as they step up and make the big play when called upon.
Dump it inside. in the lane. And he can't hit the shot.
Inside.
They work the perimeter. He shoots from the deep corner.
How about this kid, huh?
We're at the 3-minute mark. The Huskies in their 4-on-1 motion.
Dribble drive, the ability to understand when to put it on the deck and when to screen.
With 10 to shoot on the shot clock. The Huskies set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
Can't put it down. They work it around the perimeter. 2 minutes left on the game clock. The freshman. On the left side. In the lane. No!
Way to get up, big fella!
On the outside. The shot clock down to 10. And he misses the shot. And lays it in. Looking for a good shot. Around a minute remaining. Now they work it around the perimeter. Jump shot. It won't fall. Out on the left wing. Now it's all about clock management, Bill. Stopping the clock in hopes of getting the lead.
Trying to sneak their way back in.
Ball coming in from the sideline. The Huskies motion for around one.
Understanding what type of shot you want is essential in this offense.
Gus, I think they'll keep fouling until they're back into this game.
Offensively, they'll set up from the sideline. And yet another stoppage and yet another foul.
And why not?
Well, Bill, here is a player in his freshman year.
He is beginning his career as a student athlete, and that is a big deal.
Makes the foul shot. It's good. Coach calls a timeout. Back with more in a moment. And we're back, ready to get things going again after the timeout. On the right side, Drains it. And the foul will stop the clock momentarily. With the free throw.
They can set up the press.
Miss it.
Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. They work it around the perimeter. He throws it up from downtown. He misses from downtown. Up and in. Ha ha! And yet another stoppage, and yet another foul.
And why not?
The Huskies are not the greatest free throw shooting team.
Anything free, you just have to convert, Gus.
No doubt about it.
And we're ready. And we're back. Gus Johnson along with Bill Raftery with you here, ready to inbound after the timeout. On the right side. With the big shot, gets it to go. And here we have our players of the game, Bill.
Two great players, Gus, who came in with a mindset that they were going to make a difference tonight.
Well, folks, that concludes our coverage of NCAA basketball on CBS Sports. I'm Gus Johnson for Bill Raftery. Good night.